Hi, everybody. It's me. It's Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College with today's co-video. I got a lot to talk about, and there's a lot I'm not going to talk about because I'm going to have to come back to it because there's just so much going on right now, and I'll get to that in a second. What I want to start with is a new kind of a therapy that's out there. Well, first of all, let me do the usual and tell you my temperature. I am at 36.8 degrees correct or 92.2 fake degrees. I'm a little high, but I've been drinking a lot of tea because I like it. That's that, and that's why it was. I had a sip right before I took my temperature, but I'm still in a good range. One quick thing about temperature and body temperature, I'm going to have to cautiously recommend that people don't use ibuprofen for reducing fevers at this time, just until we get through this. I'm a big fan of ibuprofen as an anti-inflammatory, but I think as a fever reducer, you should kind of stick to Tylenol right now, just based on some things that we're seeing around. But I'm not going to talk about that today. What I want to talk about is I want to continue with what we were talking about yesterday and talk about the immune system. You'll remember I put this slide up and I said that first of all, you have this IgM response and then you have this IgG response. And of course, that's the way you can design nice tests and we can talk more about testing later. But I'm not going to talk about that. I want to talk about something else. And the something else that I want to talk about is how do antibodies work with respect to viruses? Well, antibodies work in a variety of ways. As you can see from this picture, there's all sorts of things that the antibody does from increasing bacterial. Most of those are bacterial kind of mechanisms. But on the in the corner of the slide, there is something called neutralization. I've actually blown that up on the next slide. Viral neutralization is when you block the receptor binding sites on the surface. Some people call them spikes, but I prefer viral receptor binding protein because it says what it does. And it binds to the receptor on the host. And so if you block them all, you've effectively coated the virus with a coating that will make it unable to insert itself into a host cell. And you can see that this there's a couple of different viruses there, including on the bottom an envelope virus that can be neutralized by blocking all the receptor binding sites. Well, there is a new protocol being tested out at Mount Sinai in New York. And of course, this is a very much an experimental protocol going on. And if it works, it's actually an old idea. And it has to do with something called passive immunization. You have two kinds of immunization. You have passive and you have active. Active is when you personally make the immune response. And passive is when somebody else's immune system does the work. For instance, we all have exposure to it either from at birth. We get either placental antibodies or also breast milk has antibodies in it. So those are passive delivered from mom. And then when they're gone, they're gone. There is no memory associated with it, but they help protect the baby for the first 6 weeks of life, 6 months of life, excuse me. That is passive. That's natural passive because that's what happens in the course of your natural life. One of the things that they're trying at Mount Sinai is they're going to take antisera from patients that have already been recovered, those that are described as recovered, and they're going to take that antisera and give it to people who are in the thick of it, and say people who are having an active disease at the moment. And the idea is that maybe these antibodies can provide some help in covering. You can see that this little slide here, let me just show you on the next slide, is the actual cartoon, is a cartoon of what the virus looks like. And those spike proteins, those viral receptor binding proteins, are the ones that we're trying to target. And if we can block them, the virus has been neutralized. And if we can neutralize the virus, we can maybe reduce the virus load or amount that exists in the patient and help them out. All right, for the next part, I wanna just address the big elephant in the room. And the big elephant in the room is that now we have the, not the honor, but the unfortunate place of number one in the world. The United States is now the number one place of cases. We lag way behind in deaths. And I gotta give credit to healthcare, people who are working in healthcare. You are doing a fabulous job. I know you are stressed. I have talked to a lot of you in the past few days, and I know you are stressed. You are doing great work, and you're helping a lot of people. We are also, you know, the flattening of the curve is what is helping us save many lives. And this is why we're able to do this. And I'll show you a little bit of data showing that the flattening of the curve is actually being effective. While I'm on this slide, I just want to say a little bit of something. I'm going to address Italy, I think, in tomorrow's co-video, but I'm going to say a really big in bocca al lupo to my Italian friends and everybody in Italy, because I'll get into more of that tomorrow about Italy. All right. So if you look at the deaths, one thing is you can look for what you want in both of these curves is for the point when the number of deaths flattens out. When the number of deaths flattens out, these are cumulative cases. When they flatten out, there is no more cases. So when the line is parallel to the horizon, horizontal, then we have achieved it. And you can see from the graph on the right-hand side that China has done it. South Korea has done it. It looks like Italy is starting to do it. And then we've got a few other places on there, like Washington State appears to be leveling, although it's a little early to tell. And this shows you where things go and basically how flat this line gets, the better. So we're going to be watching this. Jennifer Marshall is helping us accumulate some of this data. And then finally, I'm going to put some data out that was sketched out by Dustin Bunch, who's a scientist friend of mine and student of mine. And he sketched out some data looking at the number of cases. And I want you to pay special attention to the curve on the right. That curve shows you that that is the slope, the day-to-day slope. And what slope means is, rise over run. So slope, when the slope is flat, that means it's not increasing. And when the slope is facing downward, that means the cases are decreasing. We would like to see a little bit more of a downward trend. And again, I am very much an optimist, and I can kind of see a downward trend in that data. Some of my more pessimistic friends will say, no, that's neither here nor there. But I think we are doing the job of helping the healthcare people. What we have to do is delay the hit. That's our job. Delay the hit so that we can help the healthcare workers. That is how we are the helpers. By staying home, we are delaying when the big hit hits. And while this is happening, the hospitals are gathering up supplies. They're getting ready for the hit. They're getting supplies. They're ordering things. And as things become more available, they're figuring out all sorts of things that when it actually gets really bad, we'll be able to. So in summary, we've covered a lot today. There's a lot going on. And we have potentially a promising therapy. That idea that they're trying at Mount Sinai in New York is kind of an old idea that's been done before. I know back in the day with HIV, we tried to do it in HIV, and it really wasn't all that useful. But this is a much different kind of a virus than HIV, so I am hopeful that this will provide some help. Nevertheless, there's also people working on monoclonal antibodies. Those are also passive, that are kind of made in the laboratory, and you can make a bunch of them. And I'm hoping that that also, I saw a study about that a few weeks ago, and I'm hoping that progresses along fairly soon. Now I see I've run way over, so I just want to remind you all to look for the helpers, be the helpers, be good to each other, in boca al lupo, and may you persist like a lentivirus. Thank you all for tuning in.